My name is Buzz Perri. I'm the proprietor of Buzz-A-Rama, the only slot car raceway left in New York City. I used to race with friends, either in the attics or basements. They all had homemade tracks, and it was very crude in those days. And then they commercialized it, and when I saw the first track, the commercial raceway, I said, man, this is it. I gotta get into this because I know something about it. And that's how I got started. I've been here 49 years, April 21st, 1965. I just celebrated my anniversary. This was actually, at the beginning, was a family-run business. It was my father, my mother, my wife, and me, and my sister-in-law. And then as it faded, this was a fad. I ended up buying everybody out. So I'm the lone survivor. And now I just have my wife who helps me out. Yeah, I only open on weekends because I'm up there, I'm young, I'm a young guy now. And I keep getting younger. At the beginning, I was open 7 days a week, 90 hours a week. Everybody wants me to open more, but I got enough. 2 days a week is good enough for me. They're controlled by a hand controller, it's a rheostat that applies the current to the motor. So the more you pull the rheostat controller, the faster the car goes. But when you come to the turns, you have to ease up a little bit because the car's going too fast and it's going won't stay in the slot. They all have 12-volt DC motors, which is safe. You won't get electrocuted. The Blue King track is standard all over the world. It's 155 feet long. The record on that is 1.8 seconds for one lap around. It's not held at my place. It's held at some other place, maybe Florida. Well, we had a big race in 79 where they came from 17 states and 5 countries to compete for $5,000 in merchandise and prizes. That was a terrific race. Then we had another race. It was a 24-hour enduro with 8 hours in the dark. A team had to keep one car going for that amount of time. They had to have headlights on their cars. And if they fell off, you couldn't find them in the dark. We had a cracker whistle race for kids. They raced, say they did 50 laps. Then they had to run to the fueling center and eat a cracker and then whistle. And they couldn't get come back to their car until they could whistle. And with their mouth, she was terrible. It was very funny. Most of the places, there used to be 46 places that I know of. They all went by the wayside. In fact, I was threatened to leave here also because I was in the wrong zone. They didn't have a zone for this at the time. They wanted these places strictly in Coney Island area. I had to get a variance, I had to get lawyers. It cost me $10,000 for a lawyer. If there was any objections from any of my neighbors within a 200-foot radius of the place, I would have been gone. I didn't have no objections because I ran a tight ship and I was a wonderful neighbor. This is a hobby sport that's good for kids and adults. I built a party room because we do a lot of birthday parties for children. If you're between 5 and 95, you're eligible to race slot cars and have some fun. That's the whole idea behind this thing. We want to make sure you have fun.